see a red light for him. Hi, my name is Mary Garm. I'm a mentor with iLead USA here in Pennsylvania. And it is my pleasure to introduce you to the adult literacy team.
My name is Ed Lapico. I'm a corrections librarian for the Pennsylvania Department of Corrections at SCI Hopsdale.
My name is Joanne Austin. I'm the supervisor of the North Branch of the Oosterhout Free Library in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania.
I'm Elaine Stefanko, Information Services Coordinator for the Oosterhout Free Library in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania.
And I'm Richard Miller. I'm the Executive Director of the Oosterhout Free Library and System Administrator for the Luzerne County Library System.
So, Team Alt, tell me, why did you want to do this project for iLead USA?
Well, to begin with, our project reflects an essential component of any library's mission, which is basically having a positive impact on the community they serve by offering a means to improve the lives of the community members who lack basic literacy skills. Our adult literacy toolkit will directly impact the communities to make more engaged citizens, offer people means to improve employment and financial opportunities, and simply achieve a basic skill to improve their lives.
And in Pennsylvania, maybe people don't realize that 13% of the population in Pennsylvania has a low literacy level. And in the inner cities, it's even higher. So we have decided to focus our energy and our time on adult literacy.
And like any great invention, you need to have a need fulfilled. And in some cases, you don't know what the need is until something is invented. But in our case, this is something that I've heard about since I started at the Oosterhout. Our library staff encounters this question all the time from patrons. They're looking for help. They can't read. They have difficulty reading. So really our need, our project was driven by what we see, what the community needs, and it's basically a patron-driven need.
That's right, Rick. People come into the library all the time and they're asking me where they could get help. And I'm always sending them to a small community college in our area. And then I come to find out that that wasn't actually the mission of that community college. They were interested more in GED help and also help with getting a better job. So they would, anyone who was referred to them would have to be able to read a newspaper in order to take advantage of those areas. So it sort of broke my heart that there was no place that I could send our patrons to for help.
So what did you want your project to achieve, and do you think you succeeded?
Well, the main physical deliverable of our project was the component that includes the printed materials and the tablet, which we call the toolkit. It's a collection of carefully selected resources to support the teaching of basic literacy. These resources include a variety of print materials of different grades so that they can keep being used over time, as well as an iPad, which offers a technological component to our project.
And don't forget, Ed, we're making plans to get our tutor volunteers signed up for training.
One of the highlights of our program, as Elaine mentioned, it is the volunteer. We have a contact with a wonderful group of people called Tutors in Literacy. This is a statewide Pennsylvania group of volunteers. They're specially trained to help adults achieve greater literacy. And what they did for us was provide us with a list of resources. We looked for resources on our own, but they also had a great list of things that we could use to implement to help adults achieve greater literacy.
And we have a wonderful community. I partnered with a young student from a local college. He's very excited about becoming a tutor, and he has convinced some of the other college students to also become tutors. And then at another program at the library, I told them about the iLead project. And afterward, I had retired school teachers who came to me who said they would love to be tutors of adults because all their whole lives they were dealing with children. And it was something that they would like to have to be able to do.
So what were your biggest successes and your greatest challenges?
Well, some of the successes, I think, were unexpected successes. We did partnership with an ESL teacher and an ESL class, and now twice a week, that class comes for tutoring to the library. And also, that ESL teacher also told us some of the resources that we should put into our toolkits.
One of the challenges was the geographic displacement of our group. When we first applied, I was working at the same library, but since then it's changed. Two of the members work at the same library. One of them is in a branch in the same city, but I'm about 100 miles away. So we had to use the internet basically to stay in touch, email and other resources like that helped us to keep our project moving along. Another challenge is the fact of my working in a corrections institution, the technological component, the tablet that we chose, will most likely not be able to be included there, but we designed it so that there's enough print resources to still make it useful. And another success is just the fact that we do represent different kinds of libraries, public library and corrections library.
And what I thought was going to be a challenge, and that was convincing people to become involved as tutors and keeping them involved as tutors, suddenly turned into a success. Like I said before, when we partnered with students from a local college and with retired school teachers. So that has since, you know, we've gone over that hump of being a challenge and into a success.
A somewhat minor challenge for us was the distribution of the grant funds. They certainly allowed us to put together this wonderful toolkit. In our case, we knew what our need was right away and we focused on it quickly. So in our case, it would have been nice to have the funds early to assemble the kit and have time to train the volunteers and refine the kit a little better. But I think that's going to be a minor thing in the long run. But it would just would have been nice in our case to be able to have more results to show by this point in the program. But I think it's going to work wonderfully. The kits are assembled and it's been a great project for us.
With the benefit of hindsight, what would you change about your original concept?
Well, I think we did change our original concept in the very beginning. We were sort of broad-based, and we were concentrating on both the volunteer tutor and the student, and we decided to make a toolkit so that the volunteer tutor could work one-on-one with the student.
Do you think your project can be used by any library anywhere?
Yes, I'll take this one. The toolkit is the core item which can be replicated exactly, or it can be adapted to be used by any library, whether public, academic, or even in the prison environment. In conjunction with a group of tutors and a group of individuals who need assistance, it can be, you know, we've set up a model. This item can be used in any library setting.
And would you want other libraries to replicate this project, to build on it, or to redo it from scratch?
Yes, definitely. As I mentioned, we are the headquarters for the Luzerne County Library System, so in addition to piloting the program in-house, we will be sharing it with the other members of our system. And from there, we can spread out. Really, the toolkit is designed to be useful to any library. Just about any library can adapt this. It has a technology component, it has a print component. As long as you can recruit the volunteers, it's useful because in any community where there's a library, whether it's a public library, a prison library, a medical library, a school library, just about any library, you can use this, and no matter how affluent or how much poverty you have, if one person has low literacy or is illiterate, that person can't access what they need to do to get support in the American mainstream today. So this toolkit will help with that.
So to wrap up, tell me where you're going to go from here with this project, and if you can, tell me what your top resources were.
Well, I'll start with that. The top resources were, of course, the people that we came in contact with, the tutors of literacy, the ESL people, and the ALTA program at the local community college, which is like a literacy program. They were wonderful to us. They offered so many different things that we could look at from certain publishers. And then we kind of looked at those and came up with these resources and things that we put in our toolkit ourselves. And we were able to, which was great, we were able to put together 6 toolkits. One will go with Ed out to the prison, and one will come into my branch, and the rest will be at our central library downtown. And I think that, you know, whenever anyone asks, there should be a kit available, and that I think is a wonderful resource in itself. What we will begin doing now this summer is to begin training tutors. This winter, I should say, summer's gone. But anyway, we should begin training our tutors. And we're going to be taking our little project out on the road to different organizations, to different libraries, and we hope to garner some interest in our project. We want to make sure that it's marketed on our website and in our local newsletters and newspapers. And also, even though this is the end of iLead, our project is just beginning, and I hope it will stay in motion for a very long time.
Well, congratulations, Team Alta, on what sounds like a very successful adult literacy project.
Thank you.
Thank you.